We've been talking about the inner voice, our conscience. In the ancient Sanskrit language of the Vedas, it's called buddhi, the one who knows the way. Joan Boroshenko calls it our soul's compass, there to guide us on our own unique evolutionary journey. Others refer to it as our inner light, because, in a sense, it illuminates the ideal pathway for us to follow. It is said that the conscience, or soul's compass, is felt in the heart centre, near the middle of the chest. The wise ones say that our soul's compass knows the real source of joy. It will always prod us towards the right path. Our challenge is to take it as a trustworthy guide and not disobey it each time it goes against what our limited self wants. But how can we remember to tune in, to listen and follow the conscience, whose prime aim is to lead us to joy? The rule is as simple as ABC, which means always be careful. That is, we can ask ourselves as often as we can, am I forgetting my soul's compass? Then, each time we have a good thought, we should act on it as soon as possible. This will bring a deepening of contentment, an opening of the heart, a feeling of clarity, purity, and self-confidence. On the other hand, when the guidance system in the body begins to feel uncomfortable, we can cast our mind over our various activities until we identify the one which is wrong. As soon as we know the offender, we should resolve to stop doing it immediately. If we are not sure, we can wait. Making this decision and carrying it through will lift a heavy burden from our heart. In this way, we leave open the door for our happiness to come in. To become more aware of the promptings of our inner guide, some preparation is required. It might help to remind ourselves with a few small lines. Depending on our faith, we can say, my soul's compass is my best friend. It is always guiding me to joy. It is Lord Jesus, God, or my guardian angel, whispering in my ear. Following the conscience is our true strength as we journey along the royal road to a more lasting, fulfilling happiness.